The ASEAN Plus 3 Macroeconomic Research Office, or AMRO, downgrades its economic outlook for the Philippines for this year and next. For 2024, it expects Philippine GDP to hit 6.1%. That's lower than its previous estimate of 6.3%. However, that's still within the government's 6-7% target range. For next year, the growth projection is down from the previous 6.5% to 6.3%. AMRO says the Philippine government needs to address the infrastructure gap and attract more investments to boost economic growth. Meanwhile, the group also revised downward its inflation outlook for the country this year from 3.6% to 3.3%. The Philippine government targets a full-year inflation of 2-4%. In the whole ASEAN Plus region, AMRO retained its 4.4% estimate for 2024 and 4.3% in 2025, owing to favorable export prospects, firm domestic demand, and continued tourism recovery. The American Chamber of Commerce in the Philippines optimistic at least four of the priority bills they proposed to the president will be passed. These are the Create More Bill, Konektadong Pinoy Bill, Legislation for Airport Regulation, and the creation of the Department of Water Resources. These are among the 21 priority bills the Joint Foreign Chambers of Commerce submitted to the president ahead of his third State of the Nation address next week. Meanwhile, AmCham also shared there's bullish sentiment among the business community in the Philippines.
We're coming off some strong economic reforms that just raise the optimism, right? And the positive outlook, right? We're talking about the PSA amendments, the Foreign Investments Act, RTL. In the past, actually 2 years, from 2023 to this first quarter of 2024, we've actually seen an expansion of our membership from 600 to 800 now. So we've seen a 33% increase in just, you know, wanting to understand where the opportunities are in the country, and the growth in our membership often does correlate with the general sentiment about the business landscape.
The total resources of the Philippine financial system saw a 10.7% increase in May. That is according to preliminary data from the Philippine Central Bank. The resources of banks and non-bank financial institutions, which include funds and assets such as loans, deposits, and debt securities, totaled 31.79 trillion pesos as of the end of May. Now, this figure is higher than the amounts recorded in the previous months and the previous year, in fact. In the month, the total resources of banks, digital banks, and non-banks all showed year-on-year increases. 20.31%, this was the exposure of Philippine banks and trust entities to the property sector as of the end of March, according to data from the Philippine Central Bank. The figure was lower than 20.08% recorded last year, but slightly higher than the 20.17 ratio in December. A decrease in this exposure suggests that financial institutions have reduced the proportion of their loans and investments in the property sector. Data from the BSP also show investments and loans extended by Philippine banks to the real estate sector reached over 3 trillion pesos in the month, which is 3.4% higher year on year.